Especially the children that God has given. Because we do with children? Making them without instrument? Do we use them as trophies? Without? What do we do with them? To nurture them. To prepare them. To take over. So as we are talking about children in the family, we are also talking about children in the household of God. Because we have fathers, we have mothers in the world. Also, we have fathers and we have mothers in the church. A church that does not prepare our children to step into the role of father, that church is not doing very well. I remember when I was a little kid in our own local church, there were some fathers who were born in that church. So many generations of them have gone. But each time we go to the church, we find fathers. Because one generation of fathers will pass and hand over to another generation, to another generation, to another generation. And so it happens in the nation. When we talk about the founding fathers of this great country, they have still gone. But we have fathers who are taking care of this country, even right now. So, the writer of this book, Proverbs, was a man of great wisdom, who knew what was important, and wrote it down, but he had his own spirit. How many years ago was this book written? Maybe 1,000 years ago. But when we read it today, it speaks to the time in which we live. Because the same problem is there. You must always have adults, you must always have children. And what impacted children in the past are the things that are still impacting children today. Children who have had good parents in the past did better than those who didn't have. Or those who had and their parents didn't take their work. So, it is very important that we look again into this book, Proverbs chapter 4. Because it was a boy who later became a father that is speaking. So, the little kids we have in this church who think of themselves as children, yes, 20, 30 years from now, they begin to talk to their own children. It's a continuous time. And so, for my father, he says, hear my children, the instruction of the father. A father who does not give the instruction, who does not say this is what has to be, especially if you think you are just there to provide food and provide bread, you are lacking in an essential part of your assignment given to you. And that is to provide instruction and insist that those instructions be carried out. Sometimes we say that our children are too strong, they don't listen, and therefore you allow them to go. They will go like me. You won't get it again. But if you insist and place your feet on the ground and say, this is the way it has to be, because I know this is the way that it benefits you. He says, instruction of the father, and give attention to understanding, no understanding. For I give you good doctrine, do not forsake my law. When I was my father's son, you see, when I was my father's son, I paid attention to all that he said. I'm not talking to you, but I'm talking to girls. As you are talking fathers make greater impact on their daughter than they do on their son. Because your daughter looks up to you, you are the first influence in her life. And it's what she sees in you that she will transfer to her husband. If you are a father that take care of your wife. It's affecting your body. It's putting something in her. If you are a father that don't take care of the family, it's affecting your son. And they are all looking at this. And it will influence them one way or another when they grow. So it's very important, just as we come every day to pray to God in prayer, the creator of the universe, who takes care of the whole universe, which is his family. So also, the work that God has given to the Father, who is his representative on earth. You are a representative of God on this earth. You are the God that your children see with their impressionable mind before they have the concept of understanding the big God that is not seen. So, when I was my father's son, tender, and the only one in the sight of my mother, probably he was an only son. He also taught me and said to me, "Lord, you are God, return my words. Keep my commandments and live. Keep my commandments and live." This is a successful path. Because if he was a holy man, he would be talking to the children and saying, "Keep my commandments and live." Because he was a broadhead, he wouldn't be talking to the children this way. Because there's something the children will learn from him. But it's more than diligent. First of all, he was interested in the word of God. And of course, you know the word of God is the Bible says the life unto our feet. It guides us in the path of righteousness and peace. If you follow the word of God. I was listening before I came here to a preacher who was speaking in the church where there was a crisis in half of life. And he was preaching the word of God. And you could see how the members of that church were raised up by their pastor, who was their father. The pastor was very well, even in the face of tragedy, they were still close to God, offering forgiveness. You cannot offer forgiveness unless it hasn't come from a heart that has been touched by God. You can do it. It's only God that will give you that peace of mind, even in the face of tragedy, to offer word of peace. And we will smile. And that's an eloquent testimony that the Father of the church did a good work. Because some people will say, "Let's go and beg answers. Are you revenging against the devil? Don't you know it was done by the devil in a human being? Who are you revenging against?" Other people went their own way, who didn't even know what was happening, and if that people are going to revenge again. So you could see how God touched them and they rejected it. That was the fact. So also in this man, in this place, talking to a child that is sitting down, you have to learn to sit to your child down. Forget about going to get money. There was money before you came, and there will be money when you are gone. You cannot get every money in this world. You cannot. Just know that God gives you enough to be able to take care of your responsibility, and if He likes, to give you extra. But the important thing, the important assignment He has given you is in your home to take care of your household. Take care of your children. And as he's telling you here, two things. He's talking to this boy. He says, "Get wisdom. Get wisdom. And also get insight. Get wisdom and get insight. These are the things you need. If you have wisdom, you can survive anywhere and everywhere. You can always take care of yourself." And that's why, you know, even though we're talking about father today, let me chip in something, you know, to mothers. So, when you prepare your daughter very well, when your daughter is growing up, don't spend a daughter. Don't say, you know, you will, she will learn. She will not learn from anybody except from you. Nobody will teach her. And don't say you are, you know, making things easy for her. No. Tell me now what is important to survive in this life. How to cook. How to clean the house. How to take care of the household. Instilling, because these are the things she will need when you are no longer there. And if you didn't give it to her, you have done a great disservice to this child. Because she will go into her husband's house and be looking at her house. You don't know what to do. And it will cost for it, and you know ahead of time, it will cost for it. But if you have prepared her, and then she has sat to lay down and fasting, even if you are gone, you'll be okay. Wherever she goes. So also it applies to the man, to the son. Don't leave pounds and pounds of money for him. You get his own money if he has wisdom. You get his own money if he has understanding. But if you leave $1 billion for him and he doesn't have wisdom and he doesn't have understanding, and God can have insight, you have just labored in death. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You have just labored in death. You must have.
Yes.
It's a problem that people say, but when you see them, you think about it. How they thought about that program before they get it. You discover that it's something, someone who does it or who did it should be doing it. Because when you cry a talent, you eat it. Or you give it to someone. But when you don't cry, you can be thrown into the box. You are not worried about that. Hear my son, and receive my spirit. And the years of your life will be many. I have brought you in the way of wisdom. I have left you in the path. This boy that came out and went to the Bible study and sat down for 1 hour, listening to the word of God. Yes, behind his pistol in his pocket.
Okay.
And at the end of it, he pulled his pistol and shot the pastor. And shot all the people there. It's a boy to forgive. A boy to forgive. Because he doesn't have all these things you're talking about today. He doesn't have research. He doesn't have knowledge. He didn't have training. He was just standing out there. And then he saw these other people and the front of the front that they were in the city. They were not. He didn't know them. They have not come in contact with him. They haven't got anything to him. So this is why we must have to spend time to give knowledge and wisdom to our children. When you walk, your steps will not be hindered. And when you run, you will not stumble. This is 4,000 years ago, and it's still relevant to our time. Father, you stumble to your father. A big responsibility. Find time to sit down and read the word of God to your children. Even if you don't know how to interpret it, the Holy Spirit will interpret it to those children. Sometimes it's what is the pleasure of you. So that you group them so that when they walk, they will not, you know, hit that. And when they run, they will not come. Get some word of instruction and you don't let go. Keep her, for she is your life. Keep her, for she is your life. Thank God for our fathers, they're not doing too badly, but they can do better. Thank God for our mothers, they're not doing too badly, they are doing well, but they can do better. I thank God for the children God has given to us, and I pray that God will draw them unto Himself, so that they will submit to the authority of God and be nurtured by the word of God. And he goes into it and says, different in size is when you grow. And when you grow, you will not depart from sheep. You will depart from sheep. Begin in time. Don't say you will learn. If you say you will learn, you will learn it from his fear outside. He may learn it from a gang. He may learn just something that you did not even prepare for and bring it for. When your friend goes to school for his bag, look at his bag. What has he come back with? And then you find things that you didn't buy for him, then you ask questions. Where did you get it? Who gave it to you? And if you don't explain, you follow him until you recover that thing that doesn't belong to him. That is how it starts. Jumping there, jumping pencil, this little thing. And then we say it doesn't matter, but in the end, if we are in the end, it doesn't matter. Because you see, having a friend very gradually happy, a friend very gradually, and over the years, they had it. You can't change it again. But if you start a time, of course, we say in this country, you don't need to take children, that's a lie. The only thing you've been told is not to touch a child, not to harm a child. Not to do anything that will inflict injury on a child. But you have your mouth. So come on. Morning, afternoon, night. And if you talk it consistently, you will begin to think. So that's not what I asked us to do. And we shall not shy away from that. And also, look at what we read in the gospel is about God. We have a loving God. We have a loving God. And he's our first father. And then he's telling us here from verse 9 of Luke chapter 11. He says, and I tell you, ask and it will be given to you. He says to the father, ask anything you need from God so that you'll be able to do your work and it will be given to you. Seek. And you will find knock, and it will be open unto you. For everyone who asks receives. And he who seeks will find. And he who knocks, it will be opened unto him. So don't say you don't know how to dream, or you don't know what to dream, or you don't have the vision. Think, ask questions. People who are doing well, come to them. How did you dream? How did you take care of this? You know that they do not well. Ask questions. Don't shy away. And then you will find, you know, an answer. Because what father would you, if he asked, his son asked him for a fish, will he then give him a sign? We love our children. That's what God is saying. So, when your children come to you to ask for something, you always give it to them. Or if he asks for an egg, we give him a scorpion. And then if you dare, he said, then it used to come back on himself. We cannot go, we don't measure up the standard of God in any way. But we do some of these things because we love our children. But he said, if you then who are able, know how to give good deeds to your children, how much more will your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask? So the important thing is the Holy Spirit. It's not just the difference in the life of everybody in this life. If you are fully indwelled by the Holy Spirit, you cannot think evil against your neighbor. Whether it's black, whether it's white, whether it's green, instead of God, you see them as the children of God. Everyone that is created was created in the image and likeness of God. So if you have the Holy Spirit, it will prepare you to love and respect everybody. But most importantly, to discipline you enough to know how to bring their children. The fear and love of God. That's what he's telling us. Because he's the father of all of us. And he will give you what he has. I know that God will dream for all of us. But a day like this, and when we go on, we follow our lead. In any way we have been deficient, but we make us up. Because that's what we are calling. But most importantly, be close to your children. Because sometimes drop back to you are doing. Drop it. It's not as important as your children. I 7 days a week, you are out there looking for money to give to the children. And the things they need, you are not providing. Spend time, send them to church, bring them to church, sit side by side with them. To show them that this is important, what you are doing is important. When I was growing up, the elders around us, they would tell you that when your father is going to the farm, follow him. So that you know your land. You know the boundary. Because if you didn't go, he will die. And people will take that land away from you. Because he didn't show you. So also, if this is the spirit of faith, because we are children, the first duty of us. And I know that as you have sought of God, He will provide for you. Amen. It's real, all right. You as a father, you as a mother, because fathers and mothers should work hand in hand. We are only celebrating fathers today, we have celebrated mothers today. But we are now celebrating the family. We have mothers and fathers who put hands together so that the children. The gift that God has given to us, the best gift, will be taken care of. So, talk to God. Ask Him for that Holy Spirit that will enable you to get all that things right. That Spirit of God, which you have to impart into your children, to prepare them for their own life. That wisdom, that insight, that understanding is then get it, and you will not. As you walk on the way. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, I thank you because you are the best Father and you are the best Father. Help us to tap from your wisdom and your knowledge, most importantly, your Holy Spirit, so that the duties you have given to us as family, we shall get them right to honor and glorify your name. This is our prayer. In Jesus Christ.